guys, and welcome to video 13 of the Pandemic Survival Guidelines series. This video will help you to understand why a pandemic doesn't mean the end of the world. Okay, let's get started. Understanding what you need to do during a pandemic will help you realize that a pandemic is not the end of the world. You can minimize your stress levels and anxiety by simply educating yourself about the pandemic. Know what you need to do once the epidemic starts. Know how to protect yourself as well as your loved ones from getting infected. Know what to buy and practice good personal hygiene, as advised. Protect your loved ones from panicking if you or a loved one is infected or told to self-isolate. You can achieve this by being prepared before the pandemic starts and by understanding that you are not the only one affected. Know that countless people are doing the best they can to come up with a solution as well as preventative measures. So focus on keeping up to date with positive news. Stay calm by finding out what professionals are saying. Finding out and understanding what health professionals are saying about a pandemic that has everyone panicking. This will help you maintain your sanity when everyone else is losing their mind. That is why you must always keep up with information concerning a pandemic only from reputable sources such as the World Health Organization, WHO, or your local clinic. Here's how you can continue enjoying your life in a pandemic. A pandemic is not a sign that everything you are working towards is coming to an end. Its presence does not mean you should stop developing yourself financially, physically, or mentally. You can still enjoy your life while coping with a pandemic. Three effective tips to continue with your professional life from home are as follows. Tip number 1. Set up a home office. Advancing or maintaining your professional life does not have to stop because you are homebound during a pandemic. You can still achieve the same excellence that you are well known for at the office while at home. There are a few things you can do to make the home environment conducive to office work. Setting up a home office is a great place to start. Make sure your home office is as tidy as the office you usually use. If possible, you can even dress formally to give yourself and everyone around the house the sense of how important your office hours are. Allocate 6 to 8 hours to continuing with your work and do not allow any interruptions. Make sure your home office resembles your regular office where possible. Tip number 2, talk to your loved ones about the need for quiet hours. Working from home has many advantages such as controlling your schedule, working in your terms, and maximizing your time otherwise wasted traveling to the office. Nonetheless, working from home comes with its share of disadvantages, such as constant interruptions as well as noise. Therefore, talking to your loved ones about the need for quiet hours free from interruptions is essential. Make sure everyone understands that you will not tolerate any disturbances unless there is an emergency. In this way, you will be able to concentrate better, and it will show in the quality of the work that you produce. That is how you can continue enjoying your work in a pandemic. Tip number 3, understand working from home is as crucial as working from the office. The quality of your work is determined by how you approach the work you do. If you treat working from home differently from working from the office, the quality of your work will show. Avoid producing below standard practice by carrying out work you do from home the same way you handle work from the office. Keep in mind that all that matters is that you are producing quality work. Stay in touch with your supervisor and your colleagues if you are working on a project that requires communication. Three different ways of developing your relationships in a pandemic are as follows. Number 1. Stay in touch. Staying in touch with your loved ones during a pandemic is vital to keep your relationships healthy. Number 2. Help each other out around the house. If you are required to remain indoors for a certain period, you can continue growing your relationships with the people you live with by helping each other out. Assisting with household chores and taking turns minding the kids or pets can help strengthen your relationship. It is also a great way of distracting yourself from the bad news circulating. Number 3. Work on assignments with your coworkers or classmates. If you are a student, you can continue working on your assignments with other students online. If you are a working adult, you can keep with your projects or work assignments with other coworkers online. Sharing ideas, correcting each other, and coming up with new methods of tackling your work becomes more comfortable and even faster. Thank you for watching and please share this video with others.